Hi children, I am really pleased to welcome you all to max session. Hope you all received your marks of periodic assessment 1 and many of you scored a very good score. Very few students scored little less, and next time you can improve by practicing more. Okay, and max, only thing is you have to understand and practice more. Without understanding, even if you work hard, there is no meaning. So understand and then work. Okay, children. And today, before getting into session, you will have one reading fun. Okay, now I am not going to read and explain all these points. If I read the fun in this activity will be missed. So you have to read and you have to enjoy. Okay. Come on, start reading this. I will be waiting for you. You can read and do what has been underlined. Okay, try. And even if you don't try, no problem. But it's just a fun for you, so that you will have a practice of reading too. Okay, children. Now shall we get into session? If you have not completed, pause the video, take your own time, read, and then continue with that video. Is it clear? Okay. Now let me move into today's session. Today, what are we going to see? Yes, today we are going to continue with the same chapter, Simple Equations, part 13 and 14. Because this is very important basic chapter in which you should be very thorough. Because this will keep on coming till you learn. Till you are in touch with max, physics and chemistry, you will come across these variables, constants, equations, everything. It's very, very, very basic, and make your mind that you should get full mark in this chapter. In whichever way it is twisted, you should be capable of answering it. Okay, children, that's why I want you people to revise this chapter even today. Okay, again, we will plan to have a test. Okay, children? Okay, now we started with max language. What are the basic components in this language? Variables, constants, and operations. The combination of all these things, if I combine all these things, what will I get? I get some statements. In other words, I can say it to be expressions. Our face shows many expressions, crying, laughing, singing, isn't it? Our expressions. Likewise, these variables will give some mathematical expressions, like sum of, difference of, multiplication, divide. Hope you all know this proverb like. Multiply your joys, divide your sorrows. Okay, here a variable takes on different numerical value. Its value is not fixed. An equation is a condition on a variable. So only if I know what is variable, we will be able to define a equation. In equation, we have combination of operations, constants, and variables with an equal to sign. If there is no equal to sign, it is not an equation. Equal to sign will make it as an equation. This expression, 4x plus 5 is an expression. This expression is an equation when it has an equal to sign in its statement, in this statement. Is it clear? Okay, children. Now, in this chapter, after learning what is variable, constant, and what is equation, we learn to make equations from statement and also statement from equation in both ways. From statement to equation and from equation to statement. You will be asked any type of questions from this. For example, this is the statement. 1/3 of a number plus 5 is 8. What is 1/3? 1 by 3 of a number. So, into n and not sx. This is into n plus 5 is in the sense is equal to 8. So I have written a mathematical equation or mathematical expression which is called as equation from a statement. And reverse order will also be asked. If they give you an equation and ask you to write the statement, you should know to write. You can write it in your own words, but it should have a proper logic and meaning in it. Is it clear, children? Okay, after learning this, what did we learn? We learned to solve equations. Before solving equation, we should know whether the given value is a solution or not. Here is an example for that. If they ask you, check whether if the given value is a solution or not, they may ask you in two different ways. Check whether or both means the same. Okay. If the value p is equal to minus 4 is the solution of 4p minus 3 is equal to 10. Two ways of asking the same questions. So in such cases, you will start with LHS because in every equation we have two sides, left hand side and right hand side. We have to start with left hand side or we can start with right hand side in whichever we have variable. If I have variable in right hand side, I have to start with RHS. If I have variable in both the sides, you have to calculate both or LHS as well as RHS. Is it clear? Wherever we have variables, we have to start with that. If we have variables in both the sides, LHS and RHS, you have to find the value of both LHS and RHS, not only one side. Is it clear? Okay, just because you are starting with this basics, you will not come across such expressions, but better take it to your mind. If you have variables in both the sides, LHS and RHS, you have to find the value of both LHS and RHS. Here I have variable only in LHS, so I take LHS is equal to 4p minus 3. 4 into p is minus 4, 3 is minus 3. 4 fours are 16. Plus into minus, minus 16, minus 3. Minus 16, minus 3 is minus 19. And it is not equal to 10. And this is 10, my dear children, not 13. And this is not equal to RHS. Here we have RHS to be 10. But we have got it as minus 19. So LHS is not equal to RHS. Thus, p is equal to minus 4 is not the solution of the given equation. So, you should know to check whether it is a solution or not. And for next, you should know to solve an equation by the rule of transposing. Okay, better stick to the rule of transposing alone, my dear children. No need to go in for the method. Add 2 on both sides, multiply 2 on both sides. You will go in for that method only when they ask you to frame equations from the solution. Okay, so we have started with minus 2q minus 6 is equal to 0. If I transpose minus 6, it comes as plus 6. So minus 2q is equal to 6. Here, what is the relationship between minus 2 and q? Is it subtraction? This is another common error students used to do. So be careful. Here, minus 2 is fully a number. And this minus doesn't state that 2 is subtracted from q. Instead, minus 2 is multiplied with q. So, minus 2 is considered as one single entity that has to be transposed to the right hand side. So, it comes to the denominator 6 by minus 2. If I cancel minus 2 and 6, I get minus 3. Is it clear? So, what is the answer now? Minus 3 is the answer. Is it the right solution? To check it, what should I do? I have to substitute in the place of q. How will I substitute? Here, if I have minus 3 here now, so minus 2 into minus 3, minus 2 into minus 3, minus 2 into minus 3, minus 6 or plus 6? Plus 6. Why plus 6? Minus into minus, plus. Here you should not say same sign, ma'am, so we have to put bigger number sign. No, we are multiplying minus 2 and 3. We are multiplying and not adding. If I multiply the numbers, I have to multiply the signs also. So, minus into minus will become plus. Plus 6 minus 6 will become 0. So, I got RHS. Hence, it is the right solution for the given equation. Is it clear? Okay, now here is one more example for you, just to recall how to transpose number from left hand side to right hand side. Try to practice as many equations as possible. You can go beyond your book. You can take any questions from any book, even from metric books or ICT book, any book, whichever you feel, even IMO, NSO, if you have now, you can take equations from such books also. Here the question is 3 minus 2 into 2 minus y is equal to 7. Which one should I transpose first? Here I have 1, 2, 3 numbers along with this y. Which one should I transpose 3 or minus 2 or this plus 2? Very good. We have to transpose this 3 first. Okay. So if I transpose this, this 3 will become as minus 3 here in the right hand side. 7 minus 3. All other things, minus 2, bracket, 2 minus y, everything as it is you have to write. What is 7 minus 3? 4. And if I bring this 2, it comes to the denominator. So 4 by minus 2. Can I cancel this? Yes. What will I get? I will get 2 2s are 4. Okay, now in next line what will happen? I have to transpose 2. Again you will get a confusion. Ma'am, 2 minus. So when it comes here, it comes as plus 2. No, my dear children. This negative sign belongs to this y and not 2. This 2 has plus sign. And there you, ma'am, you compared multiplication like this and now here saying here it has plus and you are not seeing this operation as this negative sign as operation. No, my dear children. This I can say it as plus of minus y. Is it clear? Plus of minus y only is minus y. So again, if I see the relationship, it is in plus. So how it will go to this side? Minus only. Is it clear how this minus is different? It belongs to y and it is not the operation that is lying there. Is it clear? So we have minus y as it is. Then I will transpose minus 2 here. This minus 2 we got it from here. From the denominator the sign goes to this. So minus 2 minus 2. So on the whole I get minus y is equal to minus 4. And both the side negative, so it becomes positive. Y is equal to 4 is the right answer. Now shall we see whether the answer is right or wrong? Now I have to start with LHS. What is LHS? 3 minus 2 bracket 2 minus y. Here 3 minus 2 bracket 2 minus, what is the value of y? 4. I have substituted the value of y here as 4. So then we have 3 minus 2. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Then minus into minus will become plus 4. So 3 plus 4 is equal to 7, which is equal to RHS. So the answer is right answer. Now shall we move to the next question? Okay, this one I thought of discussing in previous class, but just because we had no time, I skipped off. Now let's discuss. The value of the variable which makes the equation a true statement. Value of the variable which makes the equation true statement. It means it satisfies the equation. What is that value of that variable called as? It is called as solution. It is S-O-L-U-T-I. I am writing in short, but you have to write fully. Okay, it is called the solution. The value of the variable which satisfies the equation is called as solution. Okay, next. Any term of an equation may be taken from one side to the other with a change in its sign. Just now we were doing that. This process is called as, what process are we doing? Transposing. What is that process called as? Transposing. P-O-S-I-N-G. Transposing. Write the spelling correctly. Okay, children. Now, and dash is a statement of equality which contains one or more unknown variable. Dash is a statement of equality. An equation itself has the answer. An equation is a statement of equality which contains one or more unknown variables. It is not necessary that you should have only one variable. Without changing the equality, we may dash the same quantity to both the side of the interchange. We may in